Hello, welcome back. Today we are going to be getting a nice shiny finish onto the McLaren. Now this stuff is very, very bad for you. 2K paint. It's not what they use on cars to get the top coat looking good. If it zooms in, that's the one I'm using, Gravity 2K at the moment. Good stuff. Anyway, I'm going to keep it running today and let's go for it. Now, other YouTubers, they're mixing a pot and stir it together. I put a big glove on. Use one of the 10mm spare pots you can get from Tamiya. Three different pipettes. Three milliliters of the 2K paint. Put that to one side and do not contaminate. Next is the activator. One mil of this is required. So we press it up to this properly. Cap on that. Finally, 1 millilitre of thinners. Three to one to one. Please note that I haven't had to put any of my pipettes into the mixture. I'm putting this into my paint mixer. I can crack on. Those two can go in the bin. Mil ultimate apex brush being used. The body and all the parts are being kept in a plastic box to try and keep dirt and dust off the model. But now, I told you this stuff's bad. The face mask. Itchy nose hole.
Also for that. How do you call that?
dampen everything to keep the dust down. The only thing I haven't got is my anti-static brush. Let's go and find it. You can tell I'm doing all this on the fly, can't you? No, that's not it. Anti-static brush.
Well, it's done.
First coat is just a tack, what they call a tack coat.
There you go, like a semi-gloss look.
A semi-gloss finish, that goes tacky to grab out of the next coat to go on.
you can see the difference.
I'm going to give them a couple of minutes to flash off. If anybody wonders why I'm wearing the same t-shirt all the time, it's an old t-shirt. I don't want to get paint or anything down some decent clothes. It's common sense, I guess. But yeah, get back onto the body. This next one is a bit of a heavier pass. This will give it more of a shine. And then the final one, you go in heavy again, and then we'll start to get some shine. And then the body has to sit for about 36 to 48 hours to cure, then we can start assembling the body together. So let's get this second layer on. As you can see, the hydrangea is starting to pop now. See, gloss is building up.
Just a couple of bits. What's coming through there? That's a plus.
Nice gloss coating. One more layer to go. Got a little bit more left. You may have noticed I didn't throw one of my playbacks away. Put a little bit more thinner in. Just a bit. Shaker. Now Martin, you may have noticed that I'm running the extractor a bit higher than normal. This stuff is vicious. I can smell it in the room now. It smells like raspberry. A really chemically stinky raspberry. I've got a room window cracked open and one in another room. As soon as this is done, I'll leave the extractor running on a low. Cover up my model and get out of the room for at least an hour. And if you're susceptible to headaches, this will give you the mother of all headaches. But what's mixing now? It's been thinned a bit more. Stick it in the ultimate apex brush. And that'll be my final coat. Cover it up. Leave it to dry for 36 hours at least. And I can get on with the chassis. And everything that mates onto. Got a little bit of matte black paint on it. But this is more or less it for the bodywork now. As the matte master would say, onwards my friends.
That is what we're talking about. Zoom in.
done and dusted. Right, yeah, because this stuff is based on super glue. I'm now going to strip all my airbrush down, get it cleaned in thoroughly. A full strip down rebuild and clean up. And then I'm getting out of here for half an hour at least. Everything's in a big plastic box sealed so no dust and dirt can get in. And hopefully we'll see what it's like on the other side. That's going to be 36 hours at least curing. So tomorrow or later this evening I might start on the chassis, engine, and I'll be building all that, and it'll be a bit fast forward on here when I upload it later. But that's this bit done. Thanks for watching. Like and subscribe if you would please. I hope you're all having a good day wherever and whatever time it is you're watching. Catch you later. Ciao, rabbies.